Hi, this video is from interview.com. interview.com is a job portal. If you're looking for a job, you can post your resume with us. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is JUnit. JUnit is a simple open source framework to write and run repeatable tests. It is an instance of XUnit architecture for testing, for unit testing frameworks. JUnit, originally written by Eric Gamma and Kent Beck, has been important in the evolution of test-driven development. Benefits. Unit testing belongs to test a single unit of code, which can be a single class for Java. JUnit helps us to code and test both during the development. JUnit ensure that the modification in the code will not break your system without your knowledge. JUnit helps to test legacy code automatically, and it is less time consuming. It helps really to test legacy code, which is, if you are doing it manually, which is really time consuming. But using JUnit test cases, it is less time consuming because it is automatic and it is very fast. The developers will have more confidence when they see the green bar while executing the JUnit test cases. I have written a small method which is going to calculate the factorial. We are going to test all the possible combination for this method. So please remember, JUnit means if you have a class and you have a lot of methods, the JUnit test cases should independently test one public method. Okay, it should not combine the methods and test. This JUnit test case method is only for this method. I would say independent unit of code in a class you should test. Okay, if it goes outside the class, just mock it. There are a lot of frameworks like EasyMock, PowerMock, Mockito. So if the call goes outside this class from this method, mock it. Only this method you should test. That's what JUnit is meant for. Okay. So I'm going to run this. I've already written a JUnit test cases with a lot of combinations. What happens if you pass 0? What happens if I pass 1? What happens if I pass from 2 to 12? What happens if I pass minus value? What happens if I pass greater than 12? I'm expecting an illegal argument exception. And here also, if it is minus 1, I'm expecting illegal argument exception and other possible values. So all the possible test cases for this method has been written. I'm going to execute this now. Let's see how exactly it works. Yes, we have got the green bar. It builds a lot of confidence when we see the green bar. This is just a simple program, but in your real life and real world scenario, the application will have a very complex code. You need JUnit test cases for more confident, and in order to maintain the code, you need JUnit test cases. Hope this video is useful. Thank you and all the best.